My name's Karyn Schwartz, and I own a small herbal apothecary in Seattle, Washington called SugarPill. I opened SugarPill almost 10 years ago after working in this community for over 30 years. We function as an intermediary between the healthcare system and not having healthcare. So people come in here for a variety of reasons. They might come in because they can't sleep, because they have a sinus infection, because they have whatever, and they're just wondering, what can I do safely on my own to take care of myself? The current status of the business is that we've been closed. I actually closed before the mandate to shut down, specifically because people come here when they're sick. And I started talking to my customers about it, I started talking to my landlord about it, and nobody was taking it seriously here yet. So I decided that since my job is to teach people how to care for themselves, that I had to set an example. So I shut my store down. And probably about a week or so later, other stores started shutting down and the city started going into lockdown. We've been able to do some limited business in the last few weeks by having people place orders either online or on the phone, and we're doing very local delivery where I literally drive to your house and drop things off on your porch. The hardest thing that I've had to do is jump through all the hoops to try to get assistance. I've applied for every grant, every loan, every program, everything. I've applied for everything. I've tried to apply for unemployment. I've tried to help my employees apply for unemployment. And I'm a smart girl. I mean, I own a business. I run a business. Like, I'm pretty savvy. And I have had the hardest time just jumping through the hoops of what is required to ask for the help that we should be getting to do what we've been asked to do. And the assistance, for the most part, is not really assistance. To apply for a loan that you'll never be able to pay back, just to pay your rent on a space you can't open, doesn't make any sense. And it doesn't make any sense to ask people to not work and then not just give them a check to pay their bills. It makes no sense. What worries me about my business, I mean, obviously, is whether or not we'll survive. But if we do survive, what worries me is that my neighborhood won't survive. Communities offer a safety net. I think one thing that people have probably realized is how important it is to our own personal mental health to just walk around in the world and see people casually and wave to the stranger whose face you recognize because you see them every day. So I may or may not make it a SugarPill, but that's not what's most important. What's most important is that our communities stay intact. And if we don't help each other do that, I'm really afraid for what will happen in a much larger way.